Hi everyone, this is Brandon here. So the war just ended, and before I show you guys the score, I'd like to show you guys this raid done by me using my sub account. So as you can see, I'm using Goby Wipe to attack this base. It's a town hall 9, and I'm using a 19 wizards with 3 golems and a CC containing a backup with dropping my king and queen. Level 15 king and queen, not too high level. Now dropping my rage spell and a jump spell and a lightning spell to take out the CC troops. CC troops containing 2 balloons, which is quite a hard CC to take out because my queen is rather low in level. To take out the CC troops is quite hard. And my king has gone down really quickly. He got damaged by the balloons. Balloons do really high damage to ground troops. So as you can see, I'm just left with my P.E.K.K.A. over there as the melee attacker. The rest are ranged attacker except my golems itself. So golems are doing a really nice job to tank the damage. So as you can see at the bottom over there, there was a Tesla trying to take out my wizards. I tried to drop some archers to distract the Tesla, but it failed. So my wizards go down really quickly. Just left that golem tanking the damage against the Tesla for the archers to take the Tesla down. So if we focus back up at my queen area, the queen is still at full blood. And then after that, she's taking out a lot of the defenses and also the structures. So now left with the witches and the wizards all going in. The golems are doing a really good job to tank the damage against the archer tower on the top and also the mortar. Especially against the skeletons, because the skeletons, they go down really quickly if you were to let them get hit by splash damage buildings, especially wizard tower and also the mortars. So that's something I like to have, which is the mortars were to attack my golem so that they tank the damage for it. Especially at this point of time whereby the witch is very near the defenses, so if the skeletons were to go down, the golems were actually be able to not take the damage. Then after that, the witches will go down. So as you can see, this is probably going to be a 3-star raid, definitely. I mean, so the P.E.K.K.A. is just banging against the wall, going in, tanking the damage for the archer over there. Then after that, now as you can see, she's just hitting the wall, trying to bust through to take out that wizard tower. So with just one smack from a level 5 P.E.K.K.A., it goes down really quickly. So the queen is still at full blood, now cloaking her just for fun and scoring us the first 3-star. So now if we take a look at the score, it's at 40-21. The war ended actually, so we did like 10 3-stars. So this particular 3-star done by War MVP is basically Havoc Gaming. So you guys should check out his channel, how he used 5 golems double jump to attack this base. It's a town hall 9, so for a town hall 10 to attack a town hall 9 is a rather easy attack. But I still urge you guys to go and take a look at it, because his deployment was really awesome and really strategically placed. So the next one I'd like to ask you guys to go and take a look is done by Random Gamer, who is Mr. Clasher. Go ahead and check out his channel. So I'll put a link in the description to all their channels. So he did an attack on number 13 using a Go Wipe. The next one is also done by Master Sin. He Go Wiped this number 14, scoring a 3-star. That was really nice. So now let's proceed on back to our base and take a look at how our war was fed. So as you can see, the top 5 bases, we didn't get a 1-star at all, because I think the opponent, they gave up halfway. So if we scroll the way down to my noob, as you can see, my noob got 3-star. So let's take a look at how it got 3-star. I usually like to see my this account getting 3-star, because the troops that they use are usually rather interesting. So as you can see, this guy is attacking me with Barbarian archers. So firstly, he started by deploying some Barbarians around the base to take out the structures on the outside, which is a really smart move. Otherwise, you might not have enough time to take out the structures. Some people have used mass dragons to try to take out this base, but they even ran out of time to take out the whole entire base. So now he's attacking on the top, taking out my town hall, and then after deploying more troops on the bottom right, CC has just came out with some random troops that I've given to myself. One of basically every troop, and then after that, Nick has given me 2 Valkyries and 2 wizards too. So we just wanted to do a little bit of fun whereby see whether the CC will do anything good, especially the Valkyries. They are good against Barbarians and archers, especially Barbarians. They get taken out by the Valkyries with one swing very easily. So just continuing the attack and speeding up the attack too, because this is definitely going to be a 3-star raid. So let's take a look at how is he going to 3-star me. Using his Barbarians and archers, basically, is going to be a 3-star. My cannon has gone down. There's no other defenses left to defend against this whole group of Barbarian archers. You don't even need to use his king and queen. Just now, scoring him at 88%, going to be 100% soon. So yeah, just a few more structures left, scoring him a 3-star from my this noob. So very nice attack from number 12, Kwang Kelvin. So very nice attack. Now let's take a look at the second attack from my main account, which I attacked this Town Hall 9. So why I attacked this Town Hall 9 was because all the rest of the Town Hall 9s were actually 3-star, and the Town Hall 10s were already 2-star. So this Town Hall 9 was only 2-star, and it was attacked by Matty. He scored 99% 2-star on this base. So I decided to give this base a go, and I was practically like almost the last attacker to attack with just 2 hours left on the clock. for the war to end, and I didn't want to waste this star opportunity. So I just carry on doing my normal attack of using Goby White. So my troops have gone all the way in, with my king and queen has gone in. So it's going to be an easy 3 star, to be honest. And now a lot of troops has gone down. So this attack was done when I was still at work. In fact, it was during my lunch break. So what happened was I attacked this base at around 1:30 PM. My lunch break was around from 12:30 to 1:30. So the war was going to end at 3:30, so I didn't want to let this war go to waste. So I just attacked it as how I usually will attack. So just going ahead to just attack it, and then after that, see whether I'll be able to score a 3 star, because it's not pre-planned or whatsoever that I was planning to attack this. I didn't even scout the base to take a look at where to attack from or whatsoever. I just go by instinct, just anyhow deploy my troops. So I was kind of rushing for time at that point of time, because I was rushing my lunch as I had to get back to work, this and that. So for those of you who do not know, I'm actually working in an insurance firm. So it's an international firm itself. So for those of you who are interested in knowing where I'm working at, obviously I won't tell you where I am, but it's based in Singapore, but it's an international company. I won't disclose the company name too, but those of you who are interested to know, you guys have to figure a way how to find it out. So yeah, this raid is basically a 3-star raid. So yeah, that's it for all the attacks that I'd like to show you guys for this particular war with YouTubers War. So if you guys want to take a look at the rest of the attacks done by my other clanmates, you guys can go ahead to their channel to take a look at it. I'll put a link in the description below, so you guys can go and watch their replays as they commented on their own attacks. So before I end off, I'd like to thank everyone who has joined me for this particular war, all the YouTubers who have collaborated with me. And definitely there'll be more of this kind of events soon, probably next month or whatsoever. But I have plans in mind to work on other stuff, especially those farming videos that you guys have been asking me, and also other series that you guys have been asking me, and also other plans that I have in mind for both of my accounts, and to show you guys some more interesting contents. So if you guys really want to see more of this kind of YouTubers War collaboration stuff, do hit a like on the video itself, and also state in the comment what you guys think and how we could improve this kind of war, maybe increasing the number to like a 30 or 40 or maybe even 50 people all together doing this video, YouTubers video war together. That would be really, really awesome. I've been getting a lot of messages from people saying that they want to join the war because they are YouTubers, this and that, with so and so subscriptions. So I do welcome you guys, even with people like having a single digit subscribers. I'm fine to have you guys come on board. In fact, I'm really happy to have you guys come on board to have this opportunity to mingle with us and network with everyone and also learn from each other. So yeah, that's it for my this particular war video with you guys. And I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.